This video is all about the quadratic function. So last time we have discussed about the quadratic equation and also the quadratic inequality. And this time we're going to discuss about the quadratic function. So when we say a quadratic function, so we are going to represent a quadratic function using table of values and also an equation. So, a quadratic function is a function that can be written in a form of y is equal to ax squared plus bx plus c, where y is the function which can be written as f of x, g of x, h of x, I of x, and so on. So, not all the quadratic function equation ay nasusulat with the y. Kasi pwede siyang masulat as f of x. This is also a function. G of x, function din yan. H of x, I of x. So, most commonly, ginagamit itong function natin, function symbol natin, if we have more than one given equation. So, hindi lang siya puro ganito, pwede rin siyang maging y. So, katulad ng quadratic equation and inequalities, we have the real numbers a, b, and c. So, where a cannot be 0 or hindi pwedeng mawala yung quadratic term natin. Kasi when we say quadratic function, it should have a quadratic term. So, a can be a positive or negative number. Dahil dito tayo magbe-base kung saan ang direction ng ating graph. So, the highest exponent of the variable is 2. So, hence, it is called a second degree function. So, ang tawag sa graph ng quadratic function natin ay parabola. So, yung parabola, it is a U-shape. So, U-shape ang parabola natin. So, sa U-shape, it can be open upward or downward. So, pag sinabi natin upward, the coefficient or the real number a is positive. So, again, pag positive ang real number a natin, the parabola opens upward. While, if the coefficient or the real number a is negative, the graph opens downward. So, paano ba yung parabola natin? So, meron tayo dito parabola na opens upward. So, pag opens upward, we have the minimum point. And then, kapag opens downward, we have the maximum point. So, kapag upward, minimum point siya, and the real number A is positive. Bakit siya minimum point? Kung makikita natin, ito na yung pinaka-minimum value na meron tayo. And then, since opens upward siya, the line is infinity. So, yan po ay extended. So, pag opens downward naman, the two lines are also extended, but downward naman. So, ibig sabihin, the value, yung value natin, pababa ng pababa. And then, it is a maximum point dahil ito na yung pinakamataas na value ng point natin. Hindi na siya tataas pa dito. So, again, we have the upward or opens upward and downward in the parabola. So, now, let's proceed. So, from a given table of values, we can identify whether the function is quadratic function or not. So, by finding the differences between dependent values, we can determine the degree of the model for data given as ordered pairs in the table. So, kapag ka sa table natin or the table values, yung first differences of the function is the same, then the model is linear or not a quadratic function. Pero, once na yung first differences niya ay hindi pare-pareha, and then we get the second differences and the value becomes the same or pare-pareha yung value, then the table of values or the model is quadratic function. So, to understand this one, so we have here an example. So we are going to observe the difference of x and y, but this time we are going to find the difference of dy. So when we find the difference of x, the difference is puro 1 yan. Dahil negative 2 minus 1 minus negative 1, it becomes negative 1. And then negative 1 minus 0 is negative 1. 0 minus 1 is negative 1. And then 1 minus 2 is negative 1. So, yung differences niya lagi magkakapareha sa first na pag pinag-subtract natin. So, kaya hindi na natin i-check yung x natin. While the y, so dito tayo mag-focus. So, sa y natin, if we found or if we solve the first difference of the y values, so 5 minus negative 3, so it becomes, so ganito natin siya isa-solve. Negative 5 minus negative 3. So meron siyang dalawang magkatabing sign. So it becomes negative 5 plus 3. So therefore, the answer is negative 2. And then next naman natin, negative 3 minus 1. It is negative 2 kasi magiging plus 1 siya. Dahil negative 3 minus negative 1, it becomes negative 3 plus 1. And then the answer is negative 2. So next naman natin is 1 minus 1. So 1 minus 1 or negative 1 minus 1, it is equal to negative 2. And then 1 minus 3 is negative 2. So, if you notice, this is the first difference. Dahil, nasa first ano pa lang naman tayo. So, this is the first differences. And then, equal na siya or we have the same value. Pag sa first differences pa lang, ay equal na siya, then the function is not quadratic. It is called linear. Ibig sabihin, if we form this into a equation, the highest degree that we have in the equation is 1. So, linear lang siya. Now, let's have the second table. So, let's try to solve the differences of y. So, let's have this 4 minus 5. The answer is negative 1. And the next 5 minus 8 is negative 3. And then 8 minus 13, it is negative 5. And then 13 minus 20, it is equal to negative 7. So, sa first differences niya, ang nakuha natin, negative 1, negative 3, negative 5, and negative 7. So, magkakaiba siya ng value. So, ang gagawin natin, we will get the second differences. So, sa second differences natin, ito yung ipagsasubtract natin. Negative 1 minus negative 3. So, negative 1 minus negative 3. So, negative times negative 3, it becomes positive. Therefore, negative 1 plus 3, it is equal to positive 2. And then, next naman natin, negative 3 minus negative 5. So, negative 3 minus negative 5. So, negative times negative 5, it becomes positive 5. So, therefore, it becomes negative 3 plus 5. It is equal to positive 2. And then, next naman natin, negative 5 minus negative 7. So, negative times negative 7 becomes positive. So, negative 5 plus 7, it is equal to positive 2. So, therefore, it is 2. So, if we notice that the second differences is equal. So, equal na siya. Or same. Pag sa second differences, nag-same na yung ating differences or same value na siya, then we can identify that this table is a quadratic function. So, this one is quadratic function. So, I will write here, quadratic function. So, sa una natin, it is not quadratic function dahil linear siya. Ngayon, it is a quadratic. Pero ma'am, paano kapag sa second differences, hindi siya pare-pareho? Tapos sa third differences siya, magiging pare-pareho. So kapag sa second differences, hindi siya magkakapareho yung value, then it is not considered as quadratic. No? Kunwari, for example, dito ay ang second differences natin, 2, 3, and 4. So let me give an example. So for example, ang nakuha natin dito ay 2, 3, and 4 sa second differences. So 2, 3, and 4. So if the second differences is not the same, we will get the next differences, which is the third. So 2 minus 3 is negative 1, and then 3 minus 4 is negative 1. So sa set as a third differences niya, same siya. But since nasa third na nga siya, it is not considered as quadratic. But we assume that the highest degree that we have in this equation or in this table of values is 3. Dahil nasa third differences na tayo. Since we are in a quadratic function, which is quadratic na, it should be on the second one. Dapat nasa second differences tayo. So the second differences must be the same para matawag natin siyang quadratic function. So ganito ang pag-o-observe natin or pag-identify ng quadratic function or not quadratic function kapag table of values. So let's try identifying the equation and the table of values if it is quadratic or not quadratic function. So first, let's have the equation. So we are going to determine whether or not each of the following is a quadratic function. So here, sa pag-a-identify natin, is we need to consider the function rule or the function symbol that we have and also the degree of 2. So, katulad lang din siya ng quadratic equation and the quadratic inequality. Pag sinabi natin quadratic equation, it must have the second or highest degree of 2 and as well, the equal sign. Kapag ka sinabi naman natin quadratic inequality, dapat meron tong inequality symbol and also the degree of 2. And then kapag ka quadratic function naman, so it must have a function or symbol of function which is pwedeng y, pwedeng f of x, g of x, h of x, I of x, and so on. And then, of course, since it is quadratic, it must have the highest degree of 2. So now let's identify the following. So number 1, y is equal to x plus 5 is considered as not quadratic function. So pwede kong ilagay NQF, not quadratic function. Bakit siya not quadratic function? Dahil if we can see or if we observe the equation or the function that we have, wala siyang highest degree of 2. So, since wala siyang highest degree of 2, it is not considered as quadratic function. Pero if you're going to identify, if this is a function, yes, this is a function. Pero, it is called linear function, not quadratic function. So, therefore, the answer is not quadratic function. So, next natin, number 2. Y is equal to x squared minus 2x plus 1. So, this one, it has a second degree or the highest degree of 2 and also the function symbol, which is y. Therefore, it is quadratic function. Number 3, x plus y is equal to negative 2. So, this one is not quadratic function dahil wala tayong highest degree of 2. Next, y is equal to x squared. So, this one is considered as quadratic function. Dahil meron nga tayong highest degree of 2 and also the function symbol or the function rule that we have. So, katulad siya ng quadratic equation and equality, wala man yung linear term or the constant term, basta meron tayong the symbol and also the highest degree of 2, it is considered as quadratic. So, this one is quadratic function. So, how about this number 5? y is equal to 3 times the quantity of x minus 7. So before identifying if it is a quadratic function or not quadratic function, of course, we need to simplify it. So pag sinimplify natin, it becomes y is equal to, so 3 times x is 3x, and then 3 times negative 7, negative 21. So the simplified form or the equation that we have is not quadratic function. Bakit po? Dahil yung sinimplify natin, wala naman tayong nakuhang highest degree of 2. So therefore, it is not quadratic function. So let me give you another one. So let's say we have y is equal to 3x times the quantity of x minus 7. So this one is, we can identify it by simplifying it first. So let's try to simplify. Y is equal to 3x times x is equal to 3x squared, and then 3x times negative 7 is negative 21x. Ayan. So since we have the function and also the highest degree of 2, it is considered as quadratic function. So that's it. So in quadratic function, that the given equation in quadratic function, to identify it, of course we need to consider the function symbol and also the degree of 2. So next is, since we know how to identify with the given or with the given equation, now let's proceed with the table of values. So of course, we are going to identify this table of values if it is a quadratic function or not. So, show your solution and justify your answer. So, we are going to show the solution and to identify if it is quadratic function or not. So, let's try this number 1. So number 1 natin, let's solve the differences ng ating y. So, the first difference is, y, 1 minus 4, it is equal to negative 3. And then 4 minus 9, it is equal to negative 5. And then 9 minus 16 is equal to negative 7. And 16 minus 25 is negative 9. Since magkakaiba yung first differences niya, we need to get the second differences. So, negative 3 minus negative 5 is positive 2. So, if we show the solution here, kung paano nakuha yung ating positive 2 is ganito po. Negative 3 minus negative 5. So, negative times negative 5, it becomes negative 3 plus 5, and the answer is positive 2. So therefore, it is positive 2. Next is negative 5 minus negative 7. It is also positive 2. Bakit po? So if we solve again, negative 5 minus negative 7. So negative times negative 7, it is equal to positive 7. So negative 5 plus 7, it is equal to positive 2. So next one, 7 minus negative 9. So this one is also positive 2. Dahil negative 7 minus negative 9. So negative times negative 9 is equal to positive 9. So negative 7 plus 9 is equal to positive 2. So nakita natin that the second differences, it has the same value, which is positive 2. So second differences na to. Since the second difference is the same, we can identify that this table of value is quadratic function. Next table, we have negative 1, 2, 5, 8, and 11 in y. So, let's find the differences, the first differences. So, negative 1 minus 2 is negative 3. And then next naman natin, 2 minus 5 is negative 3 also. And then 5 minus 8, negative 3. And then 8 minus 11, negative 3. So nakita natin that the first differences is the same. So it is not considered as quadratic function. Therefore, it is not quadratic function. Bakit siya not quadratic? Dahil first differences pa lang, nag-same na siya. This is considered as linear function. So I hope you understand how to determine whether the equation or the table of values is quadratic or not quadratic function. So thank you for listening.